Happy Mercedesing. In this video, we're going to be talking about the M103 engine. This is the fuel distributor from M103 engine. It's 300E, as I could see. Well, is this going to be just donator, just a bar for parts, or it is going to be a restoration project? Well, I've got the whole unit, you know, the airflow meter and the fuel distributor. So let's see that video about this still the dirty distributor, shall we? So hi, on our today's menu we have an M103 engine, or let's say M103 fuel distributor and the airflow meter, or what's left of it. I got this unit today. As you can see, God knows from which engine it is here. I'm going to check it and to write it then. Here it's LM0004. Well, here, let me show you how you can check for some things. This is the fuel pressure regulator line, the differential pressure line. Where does it end? It ends here. As for the rubber, it's good, as I would say. We have a tiny crack here, but as someone has taken off the part that holds the breather hose, then I think that's the reason why there is a crack. But otherwise, as I can see, no cracks, no nothing. This could be a part. We have a potentiometer and the older one. Okay, now let's measure the potentiometer, if it's good or not. So again, as we check the potentiometer, we need the negative here pin number one and the positive pin number two. What do we get? Nothing. Okay, number one and three. This one is good. Almost. Because this is the signal from the ECU. And we need from the potentiometer to the ECU. Well, then this is a bad one. As for the potentiometer, the next thing. Look at this weight here. This shouldn't be here. Well, the sensor plate does its job almost. One more thing, it should rest about here. I'll zoom in later. Or let me turn it around somehow. Here. It should rest something about like this. And look. Look at it. This is not good. Further. These three screws, they should be Torx screws, and they're for a flathead screwdriver. Now, this is a six-cylinder fuel distributor, so here, let me just show you. Here, this is the line for the fuel distributor, and this one, this is where the fuel flows in. Okay, it's a bit different. Here you measure the pressure in the lower chamber. In the upper chamber, you don't have to disconnect the cold start valve. You can simply unscrew this solo screw, as I would call it. And that's pretty much it. But concerning the state of this unit, God knows. The God himself knows when this unit saw fuel for the last time. Well, now let's undo these. Okay, now let's see the fuel distributor from underneath. Voila! I think you get the picture. At first, here, do you see the plunger? It's stuck. That's the first thing. The second thing, the shim. As I can see, this shim is broken. You know, one part of this is curved and it should be curved here, and the second one here, something like, maybe not there, no, one part should be curved here and the second one here somewhere. Another thing, as you can see, this fuel distributor is no maiden. Here, I bet that if you look closer here, this is the nut, this is the sleeve. Here, there are no 0.6 mils. I bet. Let's compare. Here. Here you can measure 0.6 mils. Here. See for yourselves. Here, not. Here, look. Someone has tried to do something with this fuel distributor. One more thing. Here. You see these? They're not meant to be for flathead screwdriver. But there you have it. Okay, look, I didn't even touch this. Here, this is the rest of the shim. Look. Here we have the plunger. And do we have the spring? We don't. We don't have a spring inside. So how was the plunger supposed to get back when you orient it like this? And when you press it, how was it supposed to get back to do this? Oh my God. So let's try to undo this one. I should have done it while on the flow meter. It's 12. There. And this one, yes, it is 13. The EHA is my way. I can do nothing here. Okay. So much about the fuel distributor. I didn't even try to undo this one. Well, let's give it a go. No way. I'll think of something. Okay, now let's look at the airflow meter. And that would be pretty much it for this video. In the second part, we're going to do the airflow meter. Well, because the video is already too long. So my dear ones, if you enjoyed this video, then please don't click the button skip ad. It is going to help me a lot. And till the next video, happy Mercedesing. Bye.